Hi, this is Kim Roberto, founder of the Scrappy Cat brand of paper crafting products. I'm proud to share that in collaboration with Spellbinders, Scrappy Cat has designed a beautiful line of new dies. In this video, I will be showing you how to create this fun and trendy card using Crafty Flower Number 1. This die was designed to make assembling dimensional flowers quick and easy. You will receive 4 pieces in this die. You will need the following pieces of cardstock and pattern paper to create this card. All cutting instructions and measurements will be included at the end of this video, so please stay tuned. Let's begin by making flower number 1. Using your teal flower petal, ink along the edges, into the debossed areas and the back. Next, pull your petals inward and fold. Using my fingers, I'm rolling the petals downward to create the desired shape. Once you have the shape, fold and set aside. Use your pink ink pad, ink your orange flowers and your petals. Using glitter glue, you're going to add a little bit of sparkle to the tips of each stamen. Set aside and let dry. Rolling the stamen has become very easy with the way we've designed this piece. Simply add a little bit of glue along the edges, and using your fingers, I'm going to roll this stamen slowly all the way up to the base, and notice that the base perfectly matches the edge of the stamen. Next, you're going to add your blue flower on top of the orange, and you're going to place the stamen into the center of the blue flower. Notice that by using my fingers, I'm molding the paper into the other piece of paper. No glue is showing, and it's perfect placement. Add a little bit of glue. Flower number 1 is now complete. Let's go ahead and make flower number 2. Flower number 2 already has the orange stamen in the center. Then I'm going to use a blue stamen and wrap it around the center. The cap will be placed underneath as I'm going ahead and molding this piece onto the base of the flower. The same technique that we used before. No glue is showing. Fluff your stamens, and there you have your flower. Add a little bit of glitter glue for sparkle, and move on to flower number 3. Notice that there's a slit in the petal. This was designed so that you will have a base. Notice how the two pieces match perfectly. Then I'm going to use the petal and roll it backwards with my finger to create additional shape. The same applies for the smaller flowers. There's a slit in the center of the petal. Fold it over to form a perfect base. Fold your petal backwards to create shape. Next, you're going to take your flowers, and because they lie flat, you have easy placement. Add the 4 on the outside. Next, move on to add your 3 inner petals. And then we're going to move along to add the stamen in the center. Notice how, using the same technique as before, we are moving the stamen to attach to the center and become part of the flower. Using petite labels number 1, cut out your tags. Using Scrappy Cat stamp, stamp the center. Add your 2 pieces together. Add 2 hole punches at the top. Attach your ribbon. And assemble your card as shown. The first flower, you're going to add the teal base, which was not shown in the beginning. I use that teal base as the center to anchor the card. And then I'm going to add the additional flowers. And look at the beautiful results. Here's some more inspiration using Crafty Flower number 1. In addition, here are some additional crafty flowers that are also available through Spellbinders that Scrappy Cat has designed, along with 3 adorable mini envelopes. Please check us out at scrappycat.net and our blog for additional inspiration.